won the first test against into spinning tracks and the bowlers can play havoc. It was a spinning track, but the man of the match, Ben Stokes, 6 wickets in the match, 103 runs in both innings, including a hard-fought 80-plus in the second innings, which actually put England on the road to victory. I think, look, the significance is not just that England have gone one up against Bangladesh in this series, but there's also a message sent, I think, to the Indian cricket team, because England are going to be here very soon, that they cannot be taken lightly. They've got depth in batting and bowling, a lot of all-rounders, Stokes, Wokes, Moeen Ali, all of whom performed extremely well. There's Adil Rashid, so they've got spin, they've got pace bowlers, and of course, they've got some solid top-order batsmen like Root and Cook, who didn't score many runs in Bangladesh, but we all know how good they are. But shifting our sights to India, India's had a fantastic weekend, as we know, winning the World Cup Kabaddi in Ahmedabad, beating Iran in the final, then beating New Zealand in the third ODI. The series was drawn, Virat Kohli playing a superb knock of 150+, Mahendra Singh Dhoni coming good with 80 batting at number 4, so there is a change of tactics there. And then of course India beating Pakistan in the Asian Champions Trophy in hockey. So all in all, a terrific past 3-4 days for India, and of course this series is still to be played out against New Zealand. I think this is a series that India should win, because they seem to be completely on